The scripture reading is two of parts. Matthew chapter 1, verse 21 says, "She will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." And Isaiah 53:7, "He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth, like a lamb that is led to slaughter, and like a sheep that is silent before its shearers. So he did not open his mouth." Amen.
On behalf of Senior Pastor, Pastor Soo-jin Lee will deliver a message on the title of The Love of the Lord. Now let's welcome her with Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Now let's greet to each other Merry Christmas. Today is a happy Merry Christmas. The blessing that Father God and the Lord gives you. Immanuel Choir and Yesu Orchestra, thank you for the praise. And Deaconess, Senior Deaconess Omijin and Sister Kim Min-jin Hee, thank you. Beautiful harp and violin play, thank you. First of all, let me introduce our precious guest for this Christmas, Pastor Jung Myung-ho and Missionary Wang Min-gi from Nairobi Manmin Church of Kenya are with us. Well, they came to Eve ceremony yesterday. It took like 24 hours to come to Korea from Nairobi, and they looked so healthy. Although, you know, they struggled in the airplane, but the Reverend Chung said, "I'm not tired. I'm so happy," he said. So they attended Christmas Eve ceremony. We also have missionaries and members from Colombia, Malaysia, and China. Now, when our guests stand up, please welcome them with your big hand. Welcome and Merry Christmas. I believe you understand the situation. Those from China cannot, you know, stand up and greet you, but you understand the situation. Yesterday, it was a Christmas Eve service and ceremony. It was a beautiful ceremony. I believe you received much grace. I give thanks to all the Performing Arts Committee members and staff. I'd like to appreciate it. You did a great job. Most of all, there was a hit. Baby Jesus. I think you were very happy. I'd like to tell you about baby Jesus and his testimony. The baby Jesus was newborn baby, Choi Yi-hyun. He was just 38 days old. Okay? 38 days old. And then their parents are Deacon Choi Hwa-suk and Deaconess Baek Hwa-suk. And whenever we have this, you know, performance, Senior Pastor always wanted to have baby Jesus to play the role of, you know, newborn baby to play as a baby Jesus without using, you know, a doll. Because, you know, we cannot, you know, ask a big boy to play a baby Jesus. So, to make it happen, we gotta have a newborn baby around that time. But since Senior Pastor said that, we always have been prepared. Father God prepared it for us. This time, I'm not sure whether he was the youngest one. He was just 38 days old. And you know, if you had a baby before, you have no idea when they cry, right? And the baby Jesus was born and everybody is cheering up and singing praises. And what if the baby is crying? So the baby is just a baby. So we cannot stop him in the crying, or we cannot ask him to laugh or smile. He cannot act. However, senior pastor believed in Father God, and he believed that everything will be in prosperity. His angels were protecting. So even though the light was so bright and there were so many people, and the big noise, but the baby was not crying. Since he believed it, you know, he always said so. And this time, again, newborn baby, very good-looking baby, played the role of the baby Jesus. All thanks to God. And their parents told me his testimony. Baby, by the name of Ihyun, this baby was riding a car in a very great manner without crying. So the parents thought that, you know, as soon as he came out of house, he felt like, he seemed like in a baby Jesus. But parents knew that, you know, they were proud of their son, you know, playing a role of baby Jesus. And then baby Jesus was, you know, slept before, right before the performance started. And then until the performance was over, it slept. The baby slept. You know, when baby is sleeping, when there is a bright light and a noise sound, you know, most parents want their child, you know, stay up, awaken. But this, in the baby, was just sleeping even before the performance. And right before the performance, they put on the dress. So the parents got worried. The baby should sleep during the performance. And then they tried to make him, you know, sleep. They fed him, you know, milk. And then the baby just ate it, but he didn't sleep. So they guessed, you know, the baby would be, you know, starving, and, you know, the baby would not, you know, sleep. They worried about it. So the baby was like smiling at the staff and the actors and actresses. The baby was awakened. 38 days old. And he was not surprised at the big noise and bright light. He was in very good condition. And the baby played a great job, awakened. And I saw him. The Virgin Mary was just the young lady, right? But Joseph was a pastor. He didn't get married. So he was not good at, you know, holding a baby. But the baby was not crying at all. He was holding a baby, and then, you know, just look at him. The baby was not, he felt a little bit awkward, but, you know, the baby, he was just holding the baby. The baby was not crying. So, well, what if, you know, the pastor is not in the good in the holding baby, but the baby was calm and, you know, sleeping well. I mean, he didn't sleep at all. He was awakened with his eyes wide open. And then all after the performance, he fell asleep. You know, when baby is starving, they cry, right? So, you know, the mother breastfed him. but it was little. But you know, since you know they received prayer, so they just expected it. But you know, after they got home, you know, the baby cried because he was hungry, and then the mother in the breast fed him, and then he went to sleep. So everything was prosperous. And then the baby was in the best condition to play a role of Jesus, baby Jesus. So I give thanks to God, who was glorified during the performance. Thank you again. There are things that people worry about, but Father God is always with us, and He does things that men cannot do. So, baby Jesus gave us joy. So I give thanks to all those actors and actresses. I would like to add you more joy. There is a Christmas message from Senior Pastor. In this December, I miss you all the more. I know there have been many trials in the church, but you've been going strong. Thank you. Although I'm not with you now, don't be hurt, but have a wonderful Christmas in the love of the Lord. Since the love of the Father God and of the Lord is always with us, we will be overwhelming conquerors. I'm looking forward to seeing you after all these trials are over. I love you. Merry Christmas. December 25th, 2019. Senior Pastor, thank you. Senior Pastor's love and expectation, I believe you grave it in your heart and enjoy this wonderful Christmas and then end this 2019, but make a great resolution for 2020, okay? Today is a happy and joyous day. It is a day the children of God can never forget and when their hearts are moved. Christmas is the day to celebrate the birth of the Savior Jesus, who opened the way of salvation for us so that we can become God's children. In Luke 2, 20-32, we found the confession of Simeon, who met the baby Jesus. He said, "For my eyes have been your salvation, which you have prepared in the presence of all peoples." As for those of us who believe in Jesus as the Christ, it is our confession. Jesus came to us as the light of the world and as the light of life. He shed His precious blood on the cross, given without price, and He opened wide the way of salvation for us. Thanks to Jesus, who shed His precious blood, you and I have been able to come to this sanctuary of God and have true joy on this Christmas day. Let us give all thanks and glory to Jesus, who came to this earth for us about 2,000 years ago, and to God the Father, who planned all these things. The title of this message is The Love of the Lord. Isaiah 1:18 says, "Though your sins are as scarlet, they will be as white as snow. Though they are red like crimson, they will be like wool." The love of the Lord is like white snow that covers the whole world with the color of white. The Lord covered our many iniquities with His warm love. To those who believe in the Lord and follow Him, the love of the Lord will be stored in their hearts. And that love will clean and purify the sins in their hearts. We live our lives celebrating this Christmas with this resolution. The love and sacrifice of our Lord Jesus Christ, that love turns into our gratitude, right? On this Christmas, especially in this December, the grace of forgiveness was much greater to me. I was forgiven. I was saved. And Father God is forgiving. The Lord died to forgive my sin. To do that, He shed His blood. And after that, after I was forgiven, He didn't condemn me. That love and grace I can feel it all the more greatly in this Christmas. I believe you can feel this grace, not just with your brain, not just the joy of salvation and forgiveness, but I hope you can feel it from the depths of your heart and make a resolution how to pay back for this grace and for this love. I hope you can enjoy this Christmas with this kind of heart. And even after this Christmas, every day, I hope you can remember this grace and love all the time. And we got to remember what happened in year 2010. It's been 10 years since December 25th, 2010. We accepted the Lord as our Savior. But even after we became Christian, we forsook the grace and love of Father God and of the Lord. And we committed sins, even sins leading to death. But God gave us another chance for forgiveness. And to make it happen, senior pastor shed tremendous amount of tears and made sacrifice for us. He warned us about the sin. We remember that. He didn't only taught us. He didn't only teach us. And he didn't only pray. He is still paying the price for us. And because of that, you know, my gratitude is overflowing. Well, trials over. I'm so fine. Senior pastor taught us with tears and sacrificed himself for our forgiveness. That sacrifice and love and prayer. And our Father God, you know, forgave again and gave us love and grace again. All those years we worked so hard in order not to commit sin, He gave us grace. I can feel the grace all the more tonight, today. Senior pastor taught us with loud voice, and he took the full responsibility for us. Even more than that, just saying, don't commit the sin. He begged, you know, forgiveness for us. Usually, the parents, when grown-ups, commit sin, the parents, punish themselves for the sin that their children committed. Parents, knelt down before their own children, shed tears, and, they took the punishment on themselves on behalf of their children to make their children change. We received that kind of teaching from our senior pastor. For the last 37 years of Manmin, especially in these 10 years, we felt it, we witnessed it. You surely repented and turned back. And if you lived like that, the joy will be much greater on this day. The price and justice our senior pastor have filled it up. Why do you feel joyous? Why do you feel, happier today? If you can feel it, that's the case. I hope that, the joy and happiness become, all the more great today. I pray in the name of the Lord that you may offer up confessions of thanksgiving and joy to the Lord who has given us this love on this happy Christmas. Brothers and sisters in Christ, Isaiah 53 verse 7 says, He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he didn't open his mouth, like a lamb that is led to slaughter, and like a sheep that is silent before its shearers, so he did not open his mouth. Isaiah chapter 53 has the prophecy that depicts the cruel sufferings of the cross for Jesus. It clearly reveals the ultimate purpose of Jesus coming to this earth in a human body. It was the way of the cross, the providence of salvation of the Father God, which He had planned since before the ages. It was the love of Father God for the mankind. The people cannot measure the depths of this love. They can never understand or comprehend His love with human thoughts. Jesus showed this impossible to measure spiritual love in this physical world. Just as Romans 5:8 says, but God demonstrates his own love toward us, in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. God loves us. It's not just a lip service. God showed us how much he loves us through his only begotten son, Jesus. Jesus' body was torn by the scourging. He was pierced by the thorns and the nails on the cross to redeem us from our own sins. He endured contempt and persecutions to take the burdens of all pains and sorrows of mankind. He did it for us, and he gave us peace. So you should be in peace. You know what? I'm under trial, so I feel tired. No way. Since our Lord took all those pains for us, and instead he gave us peace and hope for heaven. So even though your life is hard, you gotta win victory, just as our Lord did. Then you can give thanks. If your life is not in peace, then the sufferings of the Lord on the cross, the tears that our Lord shed, ask yourself whether you depend on it completely. You cannot overcome this world with your own strength. You gotta depend on the Lord. You gotta depend on the Lord, the winner. Then all the hurts, all the wounds will be healed. All kinds of sufferings will be solved, and you can have true peace. During the days of trials, I got hurt. It's so difficult. Well, don't think it anymore like that. The Lord gave us victory. The Lord gave us peace. He gave us wellness and happiness. Now, if you don't enjoy it, well, I feel sorry for that. I hope that you can enjoy the many from now on, an entire your life. So you will be overwhelming conquerors in your life. His way of cross, nobody recognized the way of sacrifice he took. But when he came down to this earth, he didn't say, I cannot help it because it is the will of Father God. Well, that's too much. I don't want to take that way. But it is the will of God, so I got to obey. He didn't say so. Instead, he came down with his love for Father God and for the souls. And he said, I will fulfill the will of the Father without fail. In order to more deeply understand and feel this love of the Lord, today, let's delve into the meanings of all the ministry of Jesus, which are also the meanings of Christmas, in three aspects. Please, you got to remember them, the sufferings of the Lord. Jesus knew that, and he came down. But he didn't take the road with difficulties. He remembered the glory and the fruits, and he took the way. So even though he was carrying the cross on Golgotha, he never said it's too much. He rather said, don't be sad, Father, because of this, thanks to what I'm doing, your providence will be accomplished. The providence of salvation will be completed. Don't be sad. He rather consoled the heart of Father God. Now, I hope you can live such a life. How beautiful confession it is. He was in such great pain. He was carrying such a heavy cross. His body shed much blood. He couldn't even walk. But he never said, it's too much. It's too heavy. It's too much burden. He didn't say so. He rather felt the sorrow of Father God and tried to comfort him. Now, we got to win victories in these days of trial like this, like him, just as our Lord did. We believe, we have confidence in the salvation of Father God and providence of Father God. So don't worry. Senior Pastor, don't worry. We are so happy It is joyful. We will win victory. We got to confess like this and live our lives. Then our rewards will be greater. After the days of trials, man, I should have given more joy. Instead of saying that, you got to say, well, my faith was that big to rejoice all the more and give thanks more. Let's become like that. After this Christmas, after 10 years of Jesus, I mean, senior pastors in the paying justice, we gotta grow up by our faith. It's like so easy to just turn your face, turn your hand in upside down. Even though you were sad yesterday, once you receive the grace of Father God, you can be happy today. So trials, these days of trials. Senior pastor embraced us, right? But the light of our shepherd was gone. But and the Father God's in a great inner comfort and strength was a little bit, you know, revealed up to give us chance to win these trials with our own strength and by our own faith. But I'm not saying that he didn't give us strength, but it was not as strong as when senior pastor was with us. Now, but by our own faith, with our own prayers, we got to win this victory with our own strength in these days of trials. Well, I believe senior pastor filled up justice for us for 10 years. Now, Father God will surely give us strength and force. I believe in that. Then, we will conquer these trials. For 3 months when I was in the prayer house, I depended on Father God. And I met you on this altar. Before that, I kind of worried. But the worries were just my fleshly thoughts as soon as I, you know, met you and stood on this altar. My thoughts were fleshly thoughts. I realized that Father God gave us comfort, joy, strength, grace, and force. He gave me more joy. Even before the 3 months period, Father God gives us even greater happiness, greater love and blessing. I've never imagined it before. But the grace, I can feel it. Aha! This is the sole grace of Father God. He made me overcome the trials with love and faith. And after that, this grace that Father God gives is a lot greater than I expected. So 3 months period was kind of blessing to me. It was a blessing. I confess now. Now people around me, you won victory. You like in a conqueror. I said to her, can I do it better? And she said, you know, sure, you can do it better. But she is so happy. Mrs. Molinney also overcome it by faith. Now, during the Daniel prayer meeting, she said, by the grace and peace that Father God gives, I win victory every day. But she said, it's different. Whenever she prays, she becomes full of grace and joy and force. And she said, she testified what she felt. So she received the answer already. She already received the answer. The problems are all solved. The enemy Satan, the enemy devil and Satan was gone. She already got blessing. Wow, the blessing, the grace that Father God gives. Well, He first checked our faith and justice that we got to fill up. But now, Father God is just giving us overflowing blessing. I realized it. I experienced it. Now, this is the blessing and grace that Father God gives to Manmin. And we will make a new history. Just like we enjoyed it with our senior pastor, the joy and blessing, the healing works will still follow us even more greatly. I hope you can become overwhelming in the conquerors and enjoy this new history of Manmin. So that, you know, you will not make the 10 years of justice of senior pastor, you know, filled in the worthless, okay? So three aspects. First, it is the aspect of justice. As I already said, Jesus came down to this earth to save souls who were sinners. But to save sinners, the price of justice had to be paid according to the law of the spiritual realm. When God sent Jesus, He is my son. He's sinless. So if you believe in him, you can be saved. No way, it's nonsense. It is against the spiritual law. So he gotta pay the price according to the spiritual law. Now, when you buy something, you cannot take it. It is stealing, okay? You gotta pay for it. Now, depending on the quality of that, you know, the subject, you gotta pay more, right? To save souls, he had to pay for the souls. For that, he sent his only begotten son. And our Jesus had to sacrifice. And he was a great sacrifice and love. We gotta understand that. Jesus is our Savior. Just knowing it, but you know, the footsteps of our Lord from his birth and the pain and the love of Father God, and it was a sacrifice of Father God. If you understand it, then joy and thanks should become greater. So we gotta understand that. As Romans 6:23 says, the wages of sin is death. All mankind were sinners, and they were destined for death according to the spiritual law. So, to unshackle this curse of the law, he took all the sins of mankind upon himself and died on the cross. But paying the price of justice does not only mean the single incident of the cross. Jesus coming down to this earth in human body itself was the beginning of the paying the price of justice. Jesus is one in origin with God, who is the same as God the Father. He had the glory and power equivalent to that of the Father God. Nevertheless, he confined his divinity in human body and experienced the limitations of the physical world. Since I'm the Son of God, you know, I'm in divine body. I'm Jesus. He didn't came down to this earth like that. He didn't do things in overcoming the limits of the world. He came in human body to this earth for us. What were the circumstances when Jesus was born? He was not born in a royal palace, nor was he laid on a comfortable bed. He was born in a shabby stable and laid in a manger for animals. It symbolizes that Jesus came to become true bread of life who would save the sinners. Moreover, he had been as wealthy as having had all the glories of heaven, but he had to live a poor life to redeem the mankind from poverty. He had to feel hunger, tiredness, sorrows, and pains, just like the fleshly people. Brothers and sisters, Jesus knew exactly when and how he was going to be crucified. Some may say it was not difficult for him to fulfill his duty of the cross, for he is the Son of the Almighty God. But the process of fulfilling the justice for forgiveness of sins was not easy, even for Jesus. Hebrews 5:7 says, in the days of his flesh, he offered up both prayers and supplications with loud crying and tears to the one able to save him from death, and he was heard because of his piety. in Gethsemane, he said, remove this cup from me. He prayed like that. He didn't take this road because it was easy. He knew it was difficult, but with obedience and love and thanks, he took this road. In this way, Jesus paid the full price through his sacrifice by fulfilling the measure of justice. He knew very well about the forthcoming sufferings of the cross, but he took each step forward, imagining the moment of glory when the way of salvation would be open. It will be difficult tomorrow. I gotta, take this cross for that soul. I came down for them, but they don't recognize me. Even though I showed many healing works and showed them love, they were surrounding me only on that moment. And they said, they followed me when they solved their problems. But, once I got arrested, they, say, crucify me. He didn't say so, and he was disappointed. He didn't say, should I die on the cross for them? He didn't say so. He died on the cross, shed his blood, only to save those sinners, betrayers, who changed their mind so easily. To help them repent and turn back to become fruits. With that mind, he took the cross. You gotta have this kind of hope and joy and thanks. This road is too much. Don't say so. At the end of this road, there will be blessing and glory. That's what our Lord thought. That's what our forefathers thought. Our workers, if you take this way, then you can work. You can work with joy and thanks. You give me trouble. Instead of saying so, think of the providence of Father God, the providence of salvation. You got to believe in and sacrifice yourself and do it with love. And when you are wrongfully accused, you can do it. You can do your job with joy and thanks. You got to do it with joy and hope and thanks. Please follow our Lord. Let's follow our Lord. Take your cross and follow me. That's what our Lord said. If we follow him, then the glory will be with us. I hope that you can spend a day giving thanks from your heart for the love of the Lord, who's dedicated all his life and eventually given his life for us. The second meaning of Jesus' ministry on this earth is love. The essence in fulfilling the measure of justice is love. Our Lord said in John 15:13, greater love has no one than this, that one lay down his life for his true friends. Jesus could willingly take the cross because he loved the souls enough to give his own life. What we gotta deeply realize here is that his love is spiritual love that gives life. Usually, people think the love is doing everything as the other people want. But that will be only fleshly love at that level. The kind of love that Jesus showed to us is spiritual love, which causes changes in hearts and gives life. He was not nice and kind all the time to those women who served him and to the disciples. Sometimes he turned his face away from them, reproached them, or gave them firm advice. For example, in Matthew 16:22, we see a scene where Peter asks Jesus not to take the cross. It says, Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him, saying, God forbid it, Lord. This shall never happen to you. Well, with fleshly feeling and fleshly heart, My Peter, you know, taking care of me. He understands my way. And since he is the top disciple, he says, you know, God forbid it, it will not happen to you. And he loves me all the more. You know, but the Lord didn't feel it this way. He rather said like this. In Matthew 16:23, he said, "Get behind me, Satan." Don't you think it's too harsh? He got no fleshly love. He didn't treat Peter with fleshly love. You know? But, you know, he gave him only spiritual love. Peter spoke the words of goodness for the Lord, but in fact, he spoke the words of flesh under the lead of Satan. Peter received the thought of Satan and spoke the words of Satan. You know, our Lord should take the cross, right? But Peter was stopping him from taking the cross. So it was fleshly words from the work of Satan. So that's why Peter, our Lord said, "Get behind me, Satan." He said to Satan, not to Peter. So in our lives, we got to discern it well. Some people, you know, try to console you and comfort you, but they can speak the words of Satan. If they do, then, I'm not saying that, you know, I'm not telling you that, you know, you gotta, you know, say, you know, "Get behind me, Satan," to your friends, okay? Let's say someone is under trials. Well, it's too much, isn't it? You're wrongfully accused, huh? Why did he say so? But it doesn't help you. You're under trials. Well, please overcome trials with joy. Well, of course, we gotta give him strength. We gotta, you know, comfort him. But we gotta say, let's, you know, overcome these trials with joy. I believe that, you know, Elder is going to overcome it. You know, because God knows it. You know, God allows it to you. If we can talk like this with spiritual love, then we can have beautiful, you know, in the Christianhood. But if you speak only the fleshly words and, you know, convey the rumors of other people, they are not for you, okay? You're speaking the words of flesh. So our Lord only spoke the words of, you know, spirit. I hope that you can open spiritual eyes and speak the words of spirit.
예수님께서는 이렇게 진정한 사랑만을 베푸셨습니다. 진정한 사랑은 무조건 감사.
True love is not just to cover and accept faults or to give full for or to be giving all the time. It is true love to show the other the right way that is truly beneficial for him. You know, if you do that, you know, at times you might feel the pain. You might have to, you know, sacrifice yourself. But if you say so, in the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, the other will change. And sometimes when you, you know, lead people in this spiritual way, you know, people may feel pain. But it is also love to endure all these things, to let him know the right way and to be patient with him so that he can go the right way by himself. Because Jesus had this kind of love, he gave the people reprimands and advice to guide them to the way of life. Indeed, he was very strict to those who could be trusted, you know, those who had no change of mind, and those, you know, Jesus truly loved. Well, when I had the conversation with senior pastor, well, Mrs. Bonin Lee was the one who was mostly rebuked. Well, I cannot remember, you know, she was rebuked recently, but sometimes the, you know, senior pastor talked about, you know, Mrs. Bonin Lee, right? But because, you know, he loves her so much, that's why he can. Sometimes, you know, why senior pastor said, he always said to me that you gotta do this, you gotta do that, you gotta put on dress like this, you gotta sing praise to Father God in this way. But, you know, senior pastor didn't say the same thing to others. You know, senior pastor don't repeat that, you know, three or four times. For fear that, you know, the other people would stumble. He gave advice only those, you know, who could be trusted, who could accept that advice with joy and thanks.
여러분 당회장과 함께했던 시간 속에 그런 지적
권유 받았던 기억이 있습니까? When senior pastors with you, you were advised, and you got to remember that, and you got to become changed. You got to change.
지금 이 시간 보내면서 당회장이 그때
This is what Lim Ni said. I can remember what he said to me.
그렇게 순종해서 그때는 못 해드렸던
것. And she obeyed. And I feel sorry for those things that I didn't obey, but I obey now, and I can change. So I'm so thankful. This is Bong Lin Lee remembered in our senior pastor, and she didn't feel sorry. Why did he say so? But instead, you know, she said, you know, she says so, I mean, he says so to make me beautiful bride of the Lord, and I'm changed, so I'm so thankful. She always says so during the Daniel prayer meeting. In these days of trial, she feels the joy, she feels the love of our senior pastor, and you receive the same love from him. Senior pastor told us about sin, and he once said that, I like to make your life comfortable and receive blessing all the time. I want to give you the prayer of blessing all the time. And I like to, you know, tell you to reduce the time for Daniel prayer meeting. I want to make you, you know, enjoy your Christmas life easily. But that's not for you. That's not the way for heaven. To go to better heaven, you shouldn't do so. For that reason, I cannot tell you them. And the pastor said like that, right? Do you remember? Then you gotta walk this narrow way now. He still says the same. He once said, quite a long time ago, he said to me, I believe 10 or 20 years ago, Pastor Myung Lee's birthday, and we usually don't have dinner together, but something happened. So since Mrs. Bong Lim Lee and Pastor Myung Lee has the same birthday, right? So we got dined together. Mrs. Bong Lim Lee said, it's her birthday, so why don't you give her encouragement? You know, she has to drive far to visit members and blah blah. And senior pastor heard it and he nodded and he said, please do more. Be more faithful. That's what he said. Wow, you drove so far. You did a good job. You didn't sleep well. He didn't say so. It was her birthday. And Mrs. Bong Lim Lee talked about all the things that, you know, she did. But senior pastor said, please do more. Be more faithful. Well, that's spiritual love. And did Pastor Myung Lee feel sorry for that? No. She took it with joy and thanks. This kind of spiritual relationship, this is spiritual love, spiritual family. You know, he talked about your spiritual sin and how Father God hates sin. He told us like that. Do you remember that? How dirty and filthy sin is. He taught us. He didn't only in the comfort of our hearts. Out of his love for us, he gave us only spiritual love and spiritual teachings. I hope you can change with that love. If you can remember this love when you undergo refinements and trials, you will surely overcome it and win victory. When you undergo trials, you know, even when you are rebuked after you worked hard, you will not grow weary or give up. You know, we gotta weep on the running horse, right? I did a good job. I worked so hard. But why am I going, you know, why am I undergoing trials? Instead, if you confess by faith, then you can overcome it with joy. You must feel that the refinement is love of the Lord who tries hard to guide you well and engrave the love in your heart. I hope you can understand what true love for the others is, as I told you a story. Senior pastor gave you this story. There was a young couple. His husband and wife loved each other so much. One day, something miserable happened. The wife lost sight in both eyes. Fortunately, she found a job that she could do even with her blindness. The husband always took his wife to work, and he always brought her back home after work. After several months, the husband told his wife, "I cannot take you to work forever. It'll wear me out. So I think from tomorrow, you should go to work by yourself. I believe that you can do it well on your own." The wife was always feeling sorry for her husband, but when she actually heard it, she was disappointed. She even felt, you know, betrayed. But she accepted the reality. So she decided to go to work all by herself. While she was bumping into many things and falling many times, she even cried with sorrow. 2 years passed by like that. It was now comfortable for her to go to work. She got on a bus and took a seat as usual. And then the bus driver said to her, "Wow, your husband is not with you today. You know, he was always next to you. You two are very famous among us drivers. You know, you must be so happy for your husband is always with you. He couldn't take his eyes off from you, probably because he was so worried about you." The wife came to know that her husband was always with her, and she burst into tears. Brothers and sisters, although we cannot see with our eyes, our Lord is always watching, and He is praying for you. He is encouraging every one of you so that you will not stop the march of faith and eventually come forth as true children of God. Don't live a poor life anymore. Don't be sick anymore. He tells us all the time. He also tells us how we can get rich, how we can be healed, and how we can live a healthy life. If you don't obey Him, however, your life will be hard and you cannot feel His love. But His reprimands and reproaches are all from His love. I hope you can always remember this love of the Lord and His earnest hope that He has for you, thereby accomplishing spirit and whole spirit quickly. The third meaning of His Jesus ministry on this earth is glory. Jesus fulfilled the way of cross with justice and love, which I have explained so far. And the fruit that He gained through justice and love is glory. Jesus fulfilled the justice with love, and now we are enabled to enjoy the authority and glory as the children of God. Jesus changed our status from sinners to children of God. Through this, Father God was greatly glorified. Through the sacrifice of Jesus, numerous children who used to belong to the enemy, devil, and Satan became brought back to God. And so this ministry of Jesus glorified God greatly. And Jesus was glorified too. It is as Philippians 2:10 says, "So that at the name of Jesus, every knee will bow, of those who are in heaven and on earth and under the earth." Whenever souls believe in the Lord and receive salvation, it becomes great glory to the Lord and to God. I thought about this. Justice, and love, and sacrifice can bring forth its fruits. As Son of God, if Jesus had been in heaven without taking the duty as the Savior, then could I go to heaven by our own faith and say, "Jesus is our Savior," and rejoice and give thanks? We can't. Aha, He is our Father God and He is Son of God. That's it. We cannot say, "He is our Savior. He sacrificed Himself for us." We cannot feel that. Now, which glory is better? Just staying in heaven as a Son of God or coming down to this earth and taking all the pain and sacrifice? There is a great difference, right? And that's, of course, of the love of Father God and of the Lord. And that's justifies, that's justice, just love, that is love, and that's glory. When we overcome all this, the glory will be even more great, even greater. So, and if his children become children of spirit and the Holy Spirit, can you imagine how greatly Father God will be glorified? Men of spirit and Holy Spirit can form with the power and authority of God and thus reveal God's glory. The powerful works manifested on this earth is the evidence through which so many souls can believe in the existence of Father God. And seeing this evidence, believers can also keep their authority as the children of God despite so many persecutions and temptations of the enemy, devil, and Satan. As we keep on increasing our faith, we will eventually come forth as true children who have faith of spirit and Holy Spirit, thereby glorifying God. The glory that we will receive, Father God knew that. That's why He allowed us refinement. Father God knew that we can reap much fruit, great fruit. That's why Father God is waiting for us to overcome trials. If we can see things by faith, we can imagine. Then trials and refinements, we can smile at them. We gotta win victory by even greater faith after this Christmas, okay? From this Christmas, when we face trials, then we gotta overcome it by faith. When you can, the answer, when you can, if you have faith, if you see eyes of faith, you can already see the answer. I hope you can grow up like that. The glory, our Father God knew, and our Lord took all the cross and sacrifice for that glory. And our Lord and Father God will be glorified through our senior pastor and through mommy and people. I hope you can understand it and overcome these trials by your own faith from this Christmas and onward. Let me conclude this message. We looked into the love of the Lord in three aspects, which are justice, love, and glory. After all, the love of the Lord is endless, and the origin of the endless God is also love. Jesus showed true love to mankind, the sacrificial love that gives life, to conform the love of God. 1 Corinthians 6:20 says, "For you have been bought with a price, therefore glorify God in your body." We must feel sorry if our fruit of change is smaller than the price that Jesus paid for our salvation. He paid the price for us. Then we gotta reap. We gotta get the fruit. Well, let's say those parents who are working together. Sometimes they pay in advance so that their children can buy some snacks in the market. They say, when my son comes back from school, he wants to buy some snacks, so give him snacks. I'll pay in advance, right? Jesus did that. Our Lord did that. If he paid $10,000, then we can buy only snacks, which is just $10,000 worth. But if you take only $10, then it's a great loss, isn't it? Our Lord paid such a great amount of price. From hell to justice, from hell to heaven. And he paid the price to lead us to New Jerusalem. He paid the price already. And our senior pastor sacrificed himself for us like that. Then we gotta go to New Jerusalem. We have to. If you go to paradise, like a first or second heavenly kingdom, then Father God would say, "I didn't cultivate you to reach that level.
참전으로 안 나왔어도 아버지 하나님은
사랑이시라 나고는 Father God is love. Okay? That's why he is leading you to Father God is giving you a chance to come to paradise in the first heavenly kingdom. But Father God sacrificed himself to gain two children who resemble our Father God completely. And our Jesus Christ paid the price already. The senior pastor knew that heart of Father God. That's why he sacrificed himself and he taught us like that. And he paid the price for justice. Then you gotta become the fruits of New Jerusalem. That's our duty. So your way is too narrow? So narrow to New Jerusalem? It is so easy? You thought it was so easy? No way. It is a very narrow and difficult way. Not many people can take the road. Only a few can go. But you say you want to go to New Jerusalem. You said you'd go to New Jerusalem. However, you don't want to try, you don't want trials, you don't want to do it easy, well, then you cannot go there. Trials and refinements, and even devil and Satan, they all try hard to stop you from going there. You work so hard to cast off sin, but they attack you to reveal your evil. Well, once you revealed it, you gotta repent and turn back and get rid of it. Are you a fool? Someone attacks you, but you stay silent? You're doing nothing? So you look full? Well, that's a spiritual victory. Then you can go to New Jerusalem. But it is too hard. You gotta hit back. You gotta, you know, slander back. Is it what you think? No way. You gotta be different if you wanna go to New Jerusalem. That's what senior pastor showed to us. We know that. So far, even though you haven't been able to do it, but you gotta do it now if you wanna go to New Jerusalem. I wanna go to New Jerusalem. That's why I'm doing it. And you gotta go to New Jerusalem too. The glory in New Jerusalem, the blessing in New Jerusalem, after all the sacrifice and love that you make, cannot be compared to that glory that you will receive. And I will take it. Even though I will look, you know, full, I will take the road to receive glory in heaven, in New Jerusalem. Don't regret. There is New Jerusalem for sure. If you live by the word of Father God on this earth, then you will go to New Jerusalem. And our Lord paid the price for that. Our senior pastor also paid the price. The sacrifice of Father God, of the Lord, and teachings of our senior pastor, you will just obey and go to New Jerusalem. I hope you can, you know, make up your mind like this on this day. Therefore, we must change to be more cleansed and beautiful in this sinful world. May you receive the Lord when He comes to take us as beautiful, adorned brides and glorious true children of God. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, I pray. I wish you a happy and Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. Let's pray together.
아버지 하나님 감사합니다. 우리를 구원하시고 참자녀 만드시기 위해 독생자 예수님을 이 땅에 보내셨고 예수님께서는 아버지의 그 뜻과 사랑을 아셔서 기쁨과 감사로 순종하셔서 이 땅에 오신 성탄절을 기념하며 오늘도 함께 예배하게 하시고 주님의 이 땅에 오신 그 모든 의미를 다시 한번 상고케 하시니 감사합니다. 이 은혜와 사랑이 우리 성도들 마음 안에 더 넘치어서 이젠 풍성하고 아름다운 열매로 예루살렘의 열매로 이루어드리는 우리 모두가 되게 하옵소서. 또한 목자님의 희생과 헌신을 기억하여 넉넉히 이기고 승리하는 성도님들 될 수 있도록 축복하여 주옵소서. 우리를 위해 땅에 오신 주님 감사와 영광을 올려드립니다. 감사드리며 우리 주 예수 그리스도 이름으로 기도하옵나이다. 아멘.
Let's receive senior pastor's prayer for the sick on screen. Lay your hand on the sick part of your body. If you are not sick, lay your hand on your chest and receive his prayer for the desires of your heart. Hallelujah, Almighty Father God of love. Please lay your hands on all those who are receiving this prayer now. Show your works that transcend space and time on those who are receiving this prayer on the internet and satellite TV and GCN in brain churches and local sanctuaries around the world. Give them the faith to believe and drive away all negative thoughts and doubts. drive away all tests and trials. From head to toe, all entrail, joints, nerves, tissues and cells, whatever the sick part may be, burn them with the fire of the Holy Spirit and with the original light. In the name of Jesus Christ, I command the enemy, devil and Satan, all diseases, germs and viruses and infirmities, go away. May the light come. Scorch all the terminal and incurable diseases with the fire of the Holy Spirit. Drive away all endemic diseases such as malaria. All contagious diseases such as cold, flu, and fever, go away. Father, protect them from all kinds of germs and viruses. Heal them of all stomach, lung, liver, breast, uterine, and intestinal cancers. AIDS, leukemia, cerebral apoplexy, high and low blood pressure, diabetes, thyroid diseases, heart, lung, women's diseases, and all inflammations, be cleansed and go away. Heal them of polio, stroke, arthritis, and herniated discs. Back pain, headache, neuralgia, and all other pains, go away. Epilepsy, autism, depression, neurosis, and other mental diseases, go away. All kinds of paralysis, be loosened, get up, walk, and leap. Let the eyes see well, let the ears hear well. Let the blind come to see, the deaf come to hear, and mute come to speak. Heal them of the after effects of all kinds of accidents and fix their broken bones. Let the heat and burning sensation go away. Restore them from burns, and let there be no burning scar left. Be cleansed from all kinds of drug addictions, poisoning, and substance abuse. Let the dead nerves, tissues, and cells be regenerated and bring the dead back to life. Give them the blessing of conception. May you receive the blessing of conception. In the name of Jesus Christ, I command the enemy, devil, and Satan, the ruler of the air, go away, and their servants also go away. Go away, you evil, unclean, false, and deceitful spirits, separating spirits and all forces of darkness. Loosen the bonds of wickedness. Darkness, you go away. May the light come. Father God, please give them strength to cry out in prayer, to cast off sin, and to be sanctified. As their soul prosper, let all things go well with them. Let their family be evangelized. Protect them from all kinds of accidents and disasters throughout this week, and bless them to lead a prosperous life without any problems. With the firewall of the Holy Spirit, with the heavenly hosts and angels, and with your blazing eyes, protect all your children, their family, workplace, and business. Give our students wisdom and understanding, and give them fervent passion to study hard. Please, keep their hearts and minds from the worldly things, and let them love Father God all the more fervently. Whether your children eat or drink or whatever they may do, let them do it all for the glory of Father God. Let them say, I met God, I experienced God, I received answers and blessings. Let them testify with their lips like this. Father God, thank you. Be glorified alone. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. 涙の中おらる主愛の主それは命与える救いの